Richmond Redevelopment and Housing Authority has a robust housing program that offers numerous benefits to property owners. By partnering with us, prospective landlords will benefit by receiving timely and consistent rental assistance payments. RRHA pays a fixed amount of the rent to you each month. The tenant pays the difference between the subsidy and the total rent, in addition to any utilities not included in the rent. You can count on these payments, and that assurance is protection and peace of mind. RRHA's Housing Choice Voucher Program's goal is to give you a thorough understanding of a Housing Choice Voucher policy and process to ensure you are successful. As an owner renting to an HCV participant, it is first important to remember that under Virginia law, all renters must be treated equally. Virginia law dictates that a renter in the state of Virginia shall not be discriminated against due to race, color, national origin, religion, sex, familial status, disability, or age. Here's what happens. RRHA and the family sign a Housing Choice Voucher Agreement. This determines the family obligations for participation in the program. RRHA and the owner enter into a housing assistance payment contract to establish a subsidy agreement. The owner and the family enter into a lease which governs the landlord-tenant relationship. The Housing Choice Voucher documents information related to the particular family, as well as information related to family obligations and facts about the HCV program. The Housing Assistance Payment Contract offers information related to the use of the HAP contract, how to complete the form, regulatory terms regarding execution of the contract, and landlord obligations in adhering to the contract. The lease offers information related to the arrangement made between the landlord and tenant regarding the occupancy and use of a dwelling unit. All leases must be at minimum executed for 1 full year. Every effort should be made to grant a reasonable accommodation that is needed to allow full access to the program for a person with a disability. Any request for a reasonable accommodation or modification should be made in writing and responded to within a reasonable time frame. The U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development offers guidance for owners when considering a Housing Choice Voucher family. Owners may use their own eligibility requirements, but those requirements may not violate HUD guidelines. Also, state guidelines must be followed closely. This protects the landlord as well as the prospective renter. Various provisions help to expand housing choice options for assisted households. For example, if the request for tenancy approval is not approved within 15 days of the person's submission, the provision does allow an owner or owner's managing agent to deny or limit a person's rental or occupancy of a rental dwelling unit. RRHA enforces provisions of the Violence Against Women Act of 2013 as set forth in our policies regarding domestic violence, dating violence, sexual assault, and stalking. Also, in adherence to VAWA, landlords may not deny assistance or terminate assistance on the basis of or as a direct result of having been a victim of domestic violence, dating violence, sexual assault, or stalking. Maintaining confidentiality throughout the entire process must be upheld. The Commonwealth of Virginia has also passed legislation that prohibits the denial of housing based on the source of a prospective family's income. RRHA works to determine eligibility for the HCV program. As an owner, your responsibility is to ensure that you are in compliance with all the agency, state, and federal required leasing regulations. The Richmond Redevelopment and Housing Authority is charged with maintaining wait lists, conducting initial background checks, and certifying program eligibility of both parties. The renter has a responsibility to provide the Housing Authority with accurate information and compliance with all regulations of the Housing Choice Voucher Program. In addition, renters are responsible for maintenance and upkeep of the dwelling, allowing physical inspection of the unit, compliance with lease terms, and timely payment of the agreed-upon rent amount. The responsibilities of the families are paramount in making this a successful partnership. Families who do not comply with these guidelines may be terminated from the Housing Choice Voucher Program. As a first-time owner, this training is mandatory in order to learn what is needed to partner with RRHA and begin renting to voucher holders and receiving your subsidies. For those who have already partnered with RRHA and are already renting to voucher holders, this portion is a good refresher. Continue watching and fill out the initial forms informing us of your background and what properties you have available, as this is the first step before anything else can be done. After the briefing is complete and your acknowledgement letter is on file with the leasing specialist, then you can move on to the next step. Step 2, advertising. RRHA currently utilizes a clearinghouse website, www.gosection8.com. RRHA is not responsible for advertising any local properties. Anything that can make your listing stand out should be added, such as details, pictures, or amenities. These are all good details to include when listing your property. So, now you've listed your property and have been contacted by a potential renter. Step 3 is the screening and selection process of the voucher holder. Again, this must be done in accordance with fair housing requirements. Also, the lease for the voucher holder should not be a different lease than what you, the owner, standardly uses. If both parties meet all requirements, the process moves on to step 4, which is request for tenancy approval. This form confirms both the landlord, property manager, and the tenant's commitment to enter into a lease agreement once all elements of the move process are complete. The form includes information related to the unit that will initiate the move process. This form must be completed in its entirety. Once this has been completed and submitted, you are now within the leasing process. This process is mandated by the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development to ensure that HCVP participants pay a reasonable amount of rent to their owners. Step 6. This is the Uniform Physical Conditions Standard Voucher Inspections, or UPCSV inspections. These inspections are to ensure that all rental units meet minimum standards of safety and decency. But let's say you get your unit inspected and it fails. If this happens, both parties will be notified. As the owner, you will be given a specified time frame to make the necessary repairs. Failing an inspection a second time will result in the unit being disapproved, and ultimately the family will be required to start their search again. The landlord can communicate with the inspections team and may be granted a final inspection once confirmation has been received that the failed items have been corrected.
There must be one working smoke alarm on each floor of the house, including the basement. If there are gas utilities or a wood-burning stove, there must be a carbon monoxide detector on one floor of the house. Breaker panels must not be locked, and there must not be any gaps or open slots. All entry doors must have a tight door seal, including weather stripping around the whole door frame. All deadbolts must be thumb latch. Double key deadbolts are not allowed. All GFCI outlets must test and reset. All outlets within 6 feet of a sink must be GFCI protected. If the outlet is not a GFCI, we will test it to make sure it is connected to one. There must be a cover for all electrical boxes so that no wires are exposed.
For stoves, regardless if it's electric or gas, all four burners have to work, and we also checked if the inside works. For landlord-provided refrigerators, we checked to make sure that it maintains a proper temperature on the inside and the freezer, and that the seals on the doors are in good condition. For water heaters, we check if it's a gas water heater, we check the flue to make sure the angles are correct. This one is electric, so there's nothing there. We also check on the discharge valve that there is a line, discharge line, or a pressure relief tube that comes down to within 12 inches of the floor. On the first floor, all windows must lock. Every window must open and stay open on its own. Every bathroom must have a working exhaust vent fan or a working window.
Okay, we're checked to make sure that every toilet in the house flushes. When there are three or more steps, there must be a handrail.
Exposed wires are considered an emergency fail and must be corrected within 24 hours.
Successfully passing the UPCSV inspection means that family and the owner can begin discussing a move-in date and security deposit. After that, it is very important that a copy of the executed lease is sent to the leasing specialist. If that does not happen, the tenant will not be able to move in. A secondary part of Step 7 outlines information that must be included on the lease. When renting to a voucher holder, the lease must include a tenancy addendum attachment. The tenancy addendum is a legally required document that must be included for anyone leasing a property who is utilizing Section 8 tenant-based assistance. It outlines payments, rent to the owner, use of the contracted unit, the lease, the family's payment of rent to the owner, termination of tenancy, security deposits, and changes in the lease or rent. When renting to a voucher participant, the landlord may require a security deposit. Security deposits are not covered under the Housing Choice Voucher Program and must be paid by the HCV participant. Step 8 in this process is the Housing Assistance Payment, or HAP contract. The HAP contract must be executed within 60 days of the lease term. Once this contract is received, RRHA will execute the contract and release the HAP payments. Step 9 details the prerequisites before HAP payments can be issued. As an owner, it is advisable that you use the landlord portal to manage your partnership with RRHA. All pertinent information concerning your subsidy payment information and inspections can be found in the landlord portal. In order to register, you must visit RRHA's website, click Landlord Portal, click here to register or log in. Enter your registration code. This code is listed on your rent notification letter or contact RRHA's call center at 804-780-4200 for assistance. Complete the following screens to establish an account. Your email address will become your username. Once you have registered successfully, you are now ready to log onto the portal. These are options you can choose. To view your account, go to Agency Management, highlighted in blue. Agency Details shows you information about your individual account displayed on the screen. Enter your registration code. This is the code that you created when you registered in the portal. If your code has been changed recently, the system will prompt you to register with another code. Your profile information can be seen under My Profile. You are able to edit your information in My Profile if something changes. Unit Info allows you to input the number of bedrooms your unit has and whether the unit is occupied or unoccupied. Caseworker Info shows you who the caseworker is for each of your residents and all their contact information. You can find attachments such as when inspections have been conducted and when they are coming up and the status, ratings from the unit inspections, ledger information, and finally, how your banking information is set up in the portal. You have the ability to change or add a bank account. As a landlord, you may request one rent increase once every year and must provide a 60-day written notice in order to do so. Other factors include, if a family wants to move, they have to provide a 30 to 60-day written notice to the owner and provide a copy to RRHA. The family must provide the landlord with a landlord certification of move. This must be completed by the landlord and turned into the assisted housing specialist who will determine the participant's eligibility to move. If after the family has gone through the process of preparing to move, but some circumstance causes them not to move as indicated, they must submit a request for an extension of their move-out date in writing. RRHA's website has additional information that can be of assistance to owners. Visit us at rrha.com and click on Housing and then Housing Choice Voucher Program. As an owner, you should also be aware of the Richmond City Health District's Lead Safe and Healthy Homes Initiative. RRHA welcomes and invites you to partner with us in providing affordable housing options for HCV participants. If you are new to this process, let's get you in the system so that you can begin leasing to qualified applicants. Complete the new landlord certification form and email it to hcvpleasing@rrha.com. Thank you for your time and attention. We look forward to working with you as we continue building communities and changing lives.